friends, today we are going to discuss finding the missing numbers. In the objective type, they may ask like the diagram of three triangles. So every triangle, there will be three values in the corners. The middle inside the triangle, there will be a value. So now totally three triangles will be given. From this, either the corner values can be asked and remaining for three values are given. Otherwise, all the corner values are given and they will ask for inside value. So this there are some types of problem in which the relationship between the inside value and the outside value will be multiples or division or average of these three corner numbers like that. Now we see the type 1 problem. In this problem, they have given the corner values of these three triangles and they are asking for the third triangle's middle value. That means inside value of the triangle. First, we have to compare these three triangles. So how to compare? Just first we try for adding these three values. So here, after adding the value, what I will get? Now I am adding the corner values 1 plus 3 plus 2, I am getting 6. After I am comparing with the 18 value with the 6, if I multiply the 6 with 3, I can get 18. This logic, I am going to try for the second triangle. For this triangle, the same thing what I have did in first triangle, I am performing here. So first of all, I am adding the corner values 2 plus 6 plus 4, I am getting 12. So the relationship between 12 and 36 is, when we multiply the 12 with 3, I am getting 36. So in the first two triangles, this logic is working. Hence, I will try for the third triangle. In the third triangle, I am having the corner values of 3, 7 and 5. Now in the third triangle, what happens is, I am adding these three corner values, 3 plus 7 plus 5, I am getting 15. So from the previous two triangles, I am directly multiplying the sum of the three numbers with the three, hence I am getting 45 is the answer. So similarly, we can do one more example under this type. Now look at this problem here. The corner values are given as 3 plus 1 plus 2, totally 6. So the 6 is related with 12 by multiplying by 2. So adding all the corners, I am getting 6. After multiplying 6 with 2, I am getting 12. So this is the first logic I am going to try. Now we try with this second triangle. So here the corner values are 5 plus 3 plus 4, that is equal to 12. Now we multiply 12 with 2, I am getting 24. So for these two triangles, the same logic is working out. So I can try for the third triangle. So now what is the third triangle? Corner value 5 plus 7 plus 6. So I am getting 18. So I have to multiply with 2, 18 into 2. Sorry, 5 plus 7. This triangle, the corner values are 5 plus 4 plus 6. So I am going to add 5 plus 4 plus 6. What happens? I am getting 15. So from the previous two triangles reference, I have to multiply 15 with 2. I am getting 30. So 30 is the answer of this question. So till now we have seen type 1 problems, two problems we have worked out. Now we move into the type 2. Here we see type 2 sum. So here the concept is average of three corner values. So the three corner values should be added first, then we have to find the average, that will be the answer. So first we have to compare these two triangles. Take first triangle, 72 plus 18 plus 33 becomes as, okay, when I add these two numbers, I am getting 123. If I divide 123 by 3, this is the average, so I am getting 41 as the answer. Similarly, I will try for second triangle. In the second triangle, I am adding these three corner values, 146 plus 7 plus 63, I am getting 216. So for finding the average, we have three numbers. So the average, for finding the average, we have to divide by 3, that I am getting the answer 72. Similarly, these two logics are working out, hence we apply for the third triangle. Now here I am adding the three corner values, 116 plus 2 plus 38, I am getting 156, that is divided by 3, hence I am getting 52. So 52 is the answer of this question. Next, we see type 3 problem. So here we have to apply this logic, multiply two corner values and add the third corner value. So here the three triangles are given. The third triangle's middle value we have to find out. First, we have to compare the first two triangles. Let me take the first triangle. 8 into 4 becomes as, sorry. Now the first we multiply the first two corner values. 8 into 4 becomes as 32. 32 plus 2 becomes as 34. So hence we are applying this logic, 8 into 4 becomes as 32, then we add the 32 with 2, we get 34. The same logic we apply for the second problem. So 12 into 5 becomes as 60. So 5 into 12 becomes as 60. Then we add the 60 plus the third corner value. This becomes 61. So this logic is working out for these two triangles. Hence we try for the third triangle. Okay. So what is the value? First two corner value is 5 into 6 becomes as 30. Now we add 30 with 3 becomes as 33. So 33 is the answer of this question. Next we see type 4. In this problem we are going to perform adding the three corner values then finding the square root of the added number. That means we take the first triangle. 2 plus 8 is nothing but 10. 10 plus 6 is equal to 16. So when we take the square root of 16, we will have the value 4. In this problem, the second triangle, we have to find the value for the second triangle, but the third triangle is given, the data is given completely. So we have to compare the first triangle with the second triangle to get a conclusion that should be applied for the middle triangle. Okay, now we leave this triangle, we go for the third triangle. So now we are going to add the corners of triangle, three corners, 18 plus 17 plus 14. Now look at the third triangle. I'm adding 18 with 17 and 14. This becomes 49. When I take square root of 49, I'm getting the value 7. Similar concepts or similar logic should be applied for the middle triangle. So here we are going to add 10 plus 19 plus 7. What happens? 10 plus 19, 29, 7, 36. So I'm going to take the square root of 36. So that is nothing but 6. So 6 is the answer of the problem. Thank you for listening to this type of problems. In the next video, we are going to see some other type of problems. Thank you.